If you guys would like to pick up any of the figures that you see in today's video, go over to ringsidecollectibleswrestlingfigures.com and use the promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, we're going to be reviewing the entire 2019 Top Picks WWE Elite Figure line featuring four of the top notable names in WWE. I love this set so much. You know, the Top Picks 2018 line was very, very good. I enjoyed it a ton. And let's hope that 2019 brings the same fire. I feel like I haven't reviewed figures in so long, guys. I feel so good reviewing these figures because it's been so long, am I right? So let's go ahead and dive right in. So just like the 2018 set, guys, this set also features the same superstars that we saw from last year's set. And this includes my boy Seth Rollins, my boy Finn Balor, AJ Styles, and are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Give me a second. Okay, now where were we? So what I was saying was this set includes three of the best figures. We got Seth Rollins, we got Finn Balor, and we have AJ Styles. All three of them look fantastic. There are some little gripes of mine that we're going to get into, guys. Of course, we do have Seth Rollins, and he is wearing the exact same attire that he wore in Elite Series 52. All they did was give us a different head scan from that figure, gave us a t-shirt, and gave us a little belt buckle, which I can appreciate, but we'll get into all that, guys. But first of all, I guess what we can do is crack them all out of their packaging, and then we will break down each superstar individually, do some comparisons, and break down everything that the figure's about. So with that being said, guys, let's go ahead and hit it. So here are all four figures out of their packaging, guys, and I gotta be honest with you, I think that this is a really strong set as far as the figures are concerned. We, of course, do have our gripes and grumbles. You guys saw where I chunked the Braun Strowman figure out of the doorway there, and the reason I did that is because we have seen this exact figure. Like, this is the exact Elite 68 Braun Strowman figure. This is the exact Elite 62 Braun Strowman figure with updated, like, the head scan is tweaked just a little bit, and then it is pretty much the Elite 52 as well. I think the boots are a bit different, and then the Elite 58 was pretty much the same figure as Elite 52 except a screaming head scan. I just wish that they would give us different patterns on the legs or something. Like, give us black pants with a cool pattern, or give us Timberland boots, like full khaki boots, or I don't know, just change it up a little bit, man. Why is it got to be the same figure with the exact same accessories for Elite Series 68 and the Top Picks 2019 figure? And then, of course, with Seth Rollins, obviously, this is Elite Series 52 with a different head scan and a painted belt buckle. This Finn Balor is not completely accurate, and this AJ Styles is pretty much perfect, but we'll cover all that stuff as we go along, guys. I guess what we can do is take a closer... God, these bugs, man. You guys pointed out in the setup. I don't know where the hell they're coming from. Where are they coming from? Look at that bug. But anyways, guys, let's go ahead and cover their accessories all together, and then we'll take a closer look at each of them individually, and we'll go through some comparisons. All right, guys, so starting off with accessories, I guess we could start off with Braun Strowman. He does come with this massive double base. I think he did a segment with Elias a while back. I think it was over a year ago now, and I think they got in a fight. I think he busted it over Elias's head, and you guys can see that it is breakaway. It's just like the guitars that we get with Elias. You know, you smash it over somebody's head. Let's go ahead and do that real quick. And this piece is so loose. What the hell? Take number two using a different method. I don't know how else to do it. I just don't. So yes, you do. That part right there is pretty loosey-goosey, so I'd be pretty careful with that. But yes, that is the double base with Braun Strowman. We also get the Money in the Bank briefcase, which I'm very excited about. I'm very happy we're getting this accessory. I do feel like it may be a little bit too small now. I feel like, you know, the other ones they used to give us were too big. This one may be just a little bit too small. Maybe it could be like medium. I don't know. It could just be me being a stupid idiot moron, idiot, dumb moron, idiot, stupid idiot. Moron. But I am happy we're getting this. The colors look nice. Everything looks good about it, and I'm happy to add this to my collection now that, you know, we'll have an accurate Money in the Bank briefcase. And then Braun Strowman finally comes with a pair of interchangeable fists. Nothing crazy. We've seen these 100 times before. With AJ Styles, you do get a terrible rubber t-shirt that says there can only be one AJ Styles. Got the Phenomenal One logo. No Phenomenal on there. On the back, you do have the AJ Styles logo at the top. And I wish they would do away with these rubber t-shirts, man. In this series, we get a cloth t-shirt, so why not just give us cloth every time. I just don't get why we do this every single time. It seems like with AJ Styles, they never give him cloth t-shirts. So I guess anytime we get an AJ, just expect to get a rubber t-shirt. You know, with Elite Series 66, we saw this exact issue. We got a WWE Championship that also comes with AJ Styles, and we've seen this 162 million times. You guys know exactly what this is. Very nice WWE Championship. And he comes with two open hands, which are the glove feature, and they do not have the texture on them like the ones that he's wearing out of the package come in, and you guys will see that later on. We saw this with the Elite Series 66 as well. For Finn Balor, we get the same terrible leather jacket in rubber, which hinders the articulation terribly, and I would totally recommend getting a custom jacket made from somebody or finding one, because these hinder the articulation so bad, guys. But this one is a little bit different than the Top Talents from last year, as in it doesn't have the rainbow BC logo, but a matte or a shiny black BC logo on top of the matte black jacket. And I like this a lot as far as the look of it. I just wish that it was cloth. If it was cloth, this would be very sick. And I have like 100 million of these and I'll never use them. And then, of course, Finn Balor has to come with his entrance posing hands, the wide open hands, you guys know, and he throws his hands up during his entrance music. So we get a pair of those. I literally have a million of these too, because I have literally 16 trillion of the 2018 Top Talents Finn Balor. And then for Seth Rollins, we have the Monday Night Rollins t-shirt. I'm very happy to get this. I already have this shirt in real life, so that's pretty cool to see this in figure form. I like the way Mattel makes their shirts. They are a bit shiny, but they fit the figure well. They don't stain your figures, and they make them look really nice, so I'm excited to have this. I'm going to do a fix-up with another one of my figures to add this to it. I'm not going to use the Elite 52. I'm going to throw the Elite 52 entrance vest onto the Top Talents Rollins with a Top Picks head scan. It's going to look freaking sweet, nasty farticles. But also, with Seth Rollins, you get a pair of open hands, and this is how I like to pose my sets, because I don't like the fists. I just don't. I like these much better, and these could also be used as fists. Like, if you're doing pick feds or whatever, this can still be used as a fist, and it can hold objects, so why ever use the fist, you know what I'm saying? Unless you're doing, like, a specific pose, like Roman Reigns or something. I don't know. I like the open hands, but that pretty much does it for all of their accessories, guys. Now that we have done that, let's go ahead and take a look at all of the figures from the 2019 Top Picks line themselves. So starting things off with Braun Strowman, guys, you will see that this is a magnificent head scan. I think it looks just like Braun Strowman. I have no complaints with this head. I think it's one of the strongest Mattel head scans they've ever done, to be honest with you. I think it literally looks identical to Braun Strowman. You can see that the beard is a bit darker than the hair, though. I don't know if that's accurate or not. I feel like it may be. I don't know if his hair on his head is that much lighter than the beard, but the likeness to Braun Strowman is uncanny. It literally looks identical to the man. But as far as the rest of the figure goes, it's pretty much identical to every Braun Strowman we've seen, and I'll do that in the next portion of the video where we do some comparisons. But going down, you have the same brown pants with the patches on there. I wish they would give us a black pants version with the camo boots. I really want to see that done. I also want to see full Timberland color boots. Are these even molded in green or tan? Because if they're molded in tan, which they may be, I'm going to totally acetone all of the green paint off of there and see what these look like, and then maybe I can do some fix-ups or something with Braun Strowman. There's really nothing crazy about this figure, guys, since we've seen it. So, is this different? Did I find the difference? Did I crack the code? Okay, so it's a little bit different than the Elite Series 62 in that it has a logo on the back of the singlet. So I did not know that, but pretty much the rest of the figure is identical to the rest of his figure. So now that we've covered Braun, guys, let's go ahead and do some Braun Strowman figure comparisons. So taking a look at some comparisons, guys, you have the brand new Top Picks 2019 in the middle. You have the Elite Series 62 on the right, and you have the Elite 58 on the left. And no bullcrap, guys, are these not the exact figures, except the head scan has True Effects technology. I mean, these figures are identical except for the little logo on the back of the singlet, and then the True Effects technology on the Top Picks. But that's not all. I want to show you guys the Elite Series 68 Braun Strowman. So here it is in all its glory. This figure right here is the Elite Series 68, and it comes with the exact same accessories as the Top Picks 2019, and you're gonna tell me that this is okay? I don't know, man, I just don't like that. I wish they would've given us a new head scan, or again, give us black pants, or give us full tan boots, or just change it up a little bit. I don't understand why they gave us the exact same figure. I don't know, that's pretty disappointing. But that pretty much does it for your Braun Strowman Elite figure comparisons. I don't have the Elite Series 52 to compare here. I wish I did, but I think I did a trade with it. But what I may do is hawk down the Elite 44, which I used to make a custom also. And then I had another Elite figure that I did a custom with. I mean, they did the same thing last year, right? I think this was the top talents, Braun Strowman, and we had the Elite Series 58 Braun Strowman. Both of those were the exact same, I'm pretty sure, as well. So I don't know. I think Braun Strowman just has a really bad complex with Mattel and producing his figures because they don't ever really change them. They're pretty much the exact same. But anyways, that does it for Braun Strowman Elite figure comparisons, guys. Let's move on to AJ Styles. So getting into AJ Styles, guys, I really do love this head scan. I think this may be the best AJ Styles head scan, and you're probably saying, well, Brad, that looks just like Elite Series 66, and you guys will see in the next portion of the video, I'm pretty sure that this one looks a little bit better. I don't know what they did, if it was different paint apps, or maybe the sculpt is just a little bit different. I don't really know what they did, but it does look better in my opinion. Going down, we still have the same terrible AJ torso. I seriously cannot stand this torso, but you know, we've got it for so long now, I've pretty much grown accustomed to it. On the armband, we do get an AJ Styles armband. It is upside down, though. It's not, you know, right side up like we saw with the Survivor Series Elite and like we've seen in other past Elites. I'm pretty sure this is the first Elite AJ Styles that doesn't have the AJ or P1 or whatever logo they put on there flipped the right side up. He also comes with his signature elbow pad. No lime green on there. I think that would have been a nice touch, but that probably wasn't accurate, so I can understand why they didn't do that. On the hands here, you guys will see, we saw this with Elite Series 66. You can see the details and the sculpt on the gloves, which I really like. I love this armband's look that they do for the gloves. I love that you can take it off and give him pretty much a gloveless AJ Styles. If you interchange some right skin tone hands, you can make him look gloveless, which is a really nice touch. I love the black and lime green. I like this attire. I wish that they didn't go with the black attire. I wish they would have went with the lime green attire with the black accents, but maybe they couldn't do that, or maybe they ran into some troubles. But the tights do look great. I love the P1 logos. All the decal stuff looks good, except for this right here. Look at this right here.
What the hell was that? God!
Check that out. What the hell is that? But besides that, I mean, the decals look really good. I like the belt. I like the belt logos. I love the AJ on the sides. I think this would be a really easy custom, guys, if you wanted to take this and just go over all the green in any color you want. I think that would be a really nice custom figure. Down here, we do get some also stuff going on. My P1 logo gets a little messed up here. The Phenomenal looks good, or the Phenomenal looks phenomenal, but the one is totally messed up here. I can easily fix that with white paint. No big deal there. This ankle is also kind of loosey-goosey, so that's kind of upsetting as well. But, you know, it is what it is. I do enjoy the figure, though. I think this is probably one of the stronger figures in the set. I think it's, if you look over the terrible body mold they gave us since Elite Series 47 with his first figure, I think this is probably one of the more stronger AJ Styles figures. I just think it looks very good. But now that we have done this, guys, let's go ahead and take a look at some AJ Styles Elite figure comparisons. So taking a closer look at some other AJ Styles figures for comparison, guys, we have the Elite Series 66 here with the Survivor Series head scan. We have my Survivor Series Elite AJ converted into an Elimination Chamber 2019 custom figure with the Elite Series 66 head scan. And then we have the Top Talents from last year, which is a pretty strong figure, but I feel like it shelf warms like a hobo. Am I insane, or is that true? Every store I go in, there's at least three of these on the shelf, and it's pretty disappointing. Maybe it's the head scan or something, but this figure is very strong, and I hate that it shelf warms so bad that it does. But taking a look at this head scan, guys, what I was talking about, like, look at the two. You're going to tell me that these are the exact same? I don't know what it is, but they look just a little bit different. Am I insane? I don't know. Maybe I am insane. I was talking to somebody earlier, and I think that it's because they shaved off some of the excess under the neck right here. You guys will see. Do you guys see under here there's like an extra flappage, and under here there's not? I think that is what the difference is. I know my boy Mac Decals on Instagram did that exact fix up. He like shaved it down with a Dremel, and it makes the head scan look 100 times better. I don't know what it is, but it just makes it stand out that much more. But I don't know. Maybe they tweak the true effects just a little bit. Maybe the beard's different. I can't figure out exactly what it is. If you guys know down in the comment section below, please let me know. But that pretty much does it for your AJ Styles figure comparisons, guys. Now let's go ahead and look at my boy Finn Balor. So taking a closer look at Finn Balor, guys, I really do not know how to feel. I used to like this head scan a lot. This is the same head scan they used for the Ringside Exclusive. But now that we've gotten it so many times, and we got the Top Talents head scan, and we've had other non-demon head scans in the past for Finn Balor, I really do not like this head scan. And I wish they would give us my biggest, like, want from Mattel, like, probably number one on my list right now, is a long beard, thick beard like this from Elimination Chamber 2018. He's probably rocking it right now a bit on SmackDown Live. Is the thick tapered beard where it goes from like really thin to thick, and then give us a better looking like faded hair head scan. Give us a faded haircut on the sides. Like, that's something I really want from Mattel. I think it would really set off our Balor collections, make the non-demon Finn Balors look that much better. I love the body mold choice that they went with. This is the perfect body mold and style choice. Every part on this figure is perfect besides the head scan. I do like that they went with the Extreme Rules attire. The only thing I don't like is, first of all, I already have a custom of this attire. I would have preferred an attire that I don't already have, but I understand that, you know, that's out of my control. But at the same time, it's not even accurate. This is more of like silver, when that attire at Extreme Rules was more gunmetal gray. Also, on the back here, they didn't include the triangle pattern from his Armani Exchange tights that he wears. There's totally a black triangle here on that attire, and we're gonna compare this figure to my custom Elite Finn Balor that I made at the beginning of this year using a Top Talents 2018 Finn Balor. But as far as the figure goes, I really do like it. Like, I love the way the kick pads look. I do. The reason that this isn't continuing, the reason that the black doesn't cover all of the pattern on the kick pads is because that he actually wore like Daniel Bryan style on this night instead of the regular, you know, the CM Punk or the Finn Balor mold. This is the Finn Balor CM Punk mold. When they could have just popped some Daniel Bryan kick pads on here, but I don't know how their factories work and everything, so that's why they made it look square instead of filling all that in. He also wore black shoes on this night, not silver, but that's not a big deal to me. I really do like the look of these kick pads, man, and I like the knee pads. I like the attire. Like, I'm probably gonna make a really sweet fix-up using this figure since I already have an Extreme Rules Finn Balor that you guys will see in the next portion of the video. But if you're really wanting an accurate full representation of Extreme Rules Finn Balor, then this is definitely not completely accurate. But again, I love the kick pads, I love the attire, and I need to figure out a sick thing to do with this figure. It's gonna take me a minute. I'm probably gonna have to sit on it for a few to figure out exactly what I want to do, but we're gonna do something epic with this. But now that we've covered that, guys, let's look at some Finn Balor Elite figure comparisons. So taking a closer look at some Finn Balor comparisons, guys, here is the brand new 2019 Top Picks Finn Balor compared to the 2018 Top Picks Finn Balor, and you guys can see it's pretty much the exact same figure, except this is the WrestleMania 34 attire and this is the Extreme Rules. You also have a different head scan. I like this head scan on the 2018 much more. I just think it replicates Finn Balor better. It has a better likeness to him. But the attire is pretty much the exact same. You have the Balor Club logo on the front, and then on the back butt cheek, you have the BC logos. And I don't know. I really do like both of them equally, just because I wasn't the biggest fan of this attire. I wish that he would have been the demon at WrestleMania. And I really enjoyed this attire, but this one's not as accurate. So it's kind of, you know, a give or take. And here's the new Top Picks Finn Balor compared to my custom from Extreme Rules. And you guys will see that this one, the custom is a lot more accurate to the gunmetal gray that he actually wore at Extreme Rules. You also have on the back the triangle pattern. I did add the triangle pattern here, and on the back they did not add it here. And then he also had, you know, a stripe going down the back of the kick pads. And these shoes are completely accurate. I just go over the top of my Finn Balor's because he's one of my favorite wrestlers. So, you know, I try my best to get as accurate as possible, so we have all the details on the shoes fleshed out and all that good jazz. I didn't do the square look on the kick pads because I didn't want to do this. I just think that looks weird. If anything, I would come in here and add a Daniel Bryan kick pad and paint over it so that you would get the square look instead of having that excess triangle look. But there is your comparison to the custom Extreme Rules to the Mattel final product. And then we have the last comparison, which is the ringside exclusive Finn Balor with a Top Talents head scan and white outsoles. And this is just, I was just trying to compare every single non-demon Finn Balor that we've gotten from Mattel thus far. And the last figure in this wave, guys, is my boy Seth Rollins. And this figure, I mean, this is a total re-release of the Elite Series 52. You got the Elite Series 57 head scan on there that we have seen multiple times. It's also the SummerSlam Elite Wave head scan that we saw, which is the Elite 57, but with the True Effects added. We've seen this torso. We've seen these arms. This is exactly the Elite Series 52 figure with a different head scan and the belt buckle added there. I will say, I think they redid the knee pads. I think they actually did the knee pads correctly this time. I remember being a gripe when the Elite Series 52 came out, when I, in my review, said I wish they would have molded the knee pads in green and then painted on the black, and that is exactly what they did. Are they listening? Are they listening? No, I don't think they are, which I think is kind of dumb. I wish they would listen, because then you would know exactly how your audience feels that buys all your figures. But that's neither here or there, guys. Going down to the kick pads, I do have a little markup somewhere. I think the markup's like down here on the ankle, and then there's a little bit of a black smudge on his foot. But this figure is pretty much the Elite Series 52, guys, so we don't really need to go into too much detail. So let's go ahead and take a look at some Elite Series figure Seth Rollins comparisons. So here we have some Seth Rollins Elite figure comparisons, guys. Of course, we have him up next to the Elite Series 52, and this is the exact Elite Series 52 figure again. Same exact figure, except with the belt buckle added. They changed up the knee pads a little bit, and they gave us a different head scan. Also, they did not include the entrance vest, which is fine because, you know, they gave us this a long time ago, and then we have the Monday Night Raw shirt, which I'm a fan of, so I really don't care. And then we have a couple figures that are most recent for Seth Rollins. You have the Elite Series 64, and you have the Elite Series, and then you have the top picks from 2018, which I think is a better figure, to be honest with you. I'm dropping Seth Rollins everywhere. He's just freaking burning down my whole setup. Oh my god, what's happening? I think I like the top picks figure from last year. I just like the armbands. I like the attire. Even though it's plain black, I just like it, man. I call this the Monday Night Rollins attire. So I think we should have got the Monday Night Rollins shirt with this figure, and I think this is the figure that shirt should go on, or the SummerSlam figure, possibly. But that pretty much does it for your Elite figure Seth Rollins comparisons to the brand new Top Picks 2019, guys. So let's go ahead and wrap everything up. But that pretty much does it for your Top Picks 2019 full Elite figure line review, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. I would love to know down below what you thought of the review, as well as what you thought of every figure individually. Do you like the Seth Rollins re-release? Do you like the Braun Strowman re-release? Do you enjoy Finn Balor? Do you like the AJ Styles? I would love to know all of that stuff down in the comments section below. Again, guys, if you would like to pick up any of these figures you see in today's video, go over to ringsidecollectibleswrestlingfigures.com and use promo code MDTOYS to save yourselves 10%. If you guys made it this far into the video and watched the full entire thing, go ahead and comment down below Monday Night Rollins. I would really appreciate it, and you will get an automatic heart from me. Overall, I really like this set. I think that there are some strong figures. There are some inaccuracies and some headaches when you look at the comparisons between, you know, re-releases and some parts and stuff like that. But I think overall it's a strong set. Is it better than the 2018 Top Talents line? I think that it is. I think that the 2019 Top Picks line is better. I wish that the attires would have been different for each person, but I like the line overall and I enjoy the figures. But thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Go ahead and subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.